School has never been easy for me. None of the other kids understand that I can't change the way I am. I was born mute and no one knows how hard it is. I always hoped that when I got older, things would be different, but nothing changed.
So this is me and here's my story. My name's Margaret, and I wasn't always like this. Ever since the crash, I could never hear the same. Actually, I can't even hear at all. I moved to this town last year and I only have about one friend. Besides Allie, I am outcasted from all the normal popular kids in school. I never get invited anywhere.
Oh. You're so mean.
There's going to be a test on this next class, what we just went over, okay? So study up on it, it'll be worth it.
Don't know?
After studying that day, we had dinner together, and it was the most fun I've had in a while.
You
are you kidding me?
Sorry.
I'm like SE.
I'm
going to
hit someone with my chipstick.
Once I started hanging out with Matt, I started to care less about what all the other kids thought of me. Allie and Chad, their opinions started to not matter as much.
My head is stuck in the clouds. She begs me to come down, says boy, quit fooling around. I told her I love the view from up here. Warm sun and wind in my ear will watch the world from above as it turns to the rhythm of love. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun you're mine, all mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love. Like a drum, a guitar string to the strum, a beautiful song to be sung. She's got blue eyes deep like the sea that roll back when she's laughing at me. She rises up like the tide the moment her lips meet mine. Keep you in my mind, the way you make love so fine. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine, all mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love.
Yeah, you could say my friends were being pretty mean, but everything changed when I came home one day to an email from my hearing doctor saying that they could fix everything.
Margaret, can you hear me?
Can you hear me? Hello?
I'm gonna remove the gauze now. Can you hear me? The surgery went well. There's no major complications. We're just going to check your vitals, and you should be good to go in about an hour.
Once I got my hearing back, I knew things would never be the same. This was life-changing.
Oh no. What time is that?
It was the first time Allie had invited me somewhere in a while, and I was really excited, not to mention kind of nervous.
Come in!
Excuse me? Have you seen Allie?
She went upstairs.
Pick it up.
Allie, are you in there?
What?
Oh, Margaret, wait.
She probably moved on after the surgery. I'm worthless to her.
I should have never left Matt when he meant so much to me. I'll go to his house tomorrow morning. I'll surprise him.
What if I never see her again?
I'm gonna tell him how sorry I am for everything.
She's probably not even sorry for any of it.
Pick it up, and start again. You've got a second chance, you could go home, escape it all, it's just irrelevant. It's just medicine. Just medicine. You could still be what you want to, what you said you were when I met you. You've got a warm heart, you've got a beautiful brain, but disintegrating from all the medicine, from all the medicine, from all the medicine. When I met you, when you met me, when I